y'all still there? It's the feeling chill about to bring the real back.
Hello guys, I'm here with Chill Moody.
What's going on?
For people that are just tuning in, tell them who Chill Moody is.
Chill Moody, I'm a hip hop artist from West Philadelphia.
When I first met Chill, I gotta tell you about this. I thought I was going to a video shoot or whatever, and he was laying on the floor with blood, and it's like tuxedo thing. It sounds just follow me.
Yeah.
And like we were running, and I was like, oh, I hope I don't step on you. He was like, don't step on me. I was like, oh, who gave you the name Chill?
My aunt dog, she named me Chill. When I was six months, before I was one. The true story is, which I just found out, is I always cry. And I only would stop crying when she put on Chili Go with a finger. That used to come on, it was maybe before your time, but it used to come on. It used to come on with Woody Woodpecker. It was like a little spinoff of that. And she said that's the only time I wouldn't cry. And she said I looked like him too, so she started calling me Chill. So that's where it really came from. That's
my
dad. I used to correct teachers, yo, that's not my name. My name is Chill. I still have never heard my father say my real name, maybe once in my entire life.
Can I ask what your real name is?
You can.
What's your real name?
I'm not going to tell you. My first name was almost Sebastian.
Oh, that's so cute! I was walking down the street and I saw one of your stickers on the, a telephone pole. I'm nice thing. Got stickers. So, about nice things, he's wearing this amazing t-shirt. Where did that movement come about?
Nice things is something we've been saying in my family since maybe I was 10. It just comes from right down the street, right down here on 51st and Cabin.
So we right in your hometown, when you grew up?
Pretty much it. My cousin's block down the street, 50th and Cabin, we call it the dorm. That's where they have their own lingo. They always just say nice things. You might not have a lot, but appreciate that you have nice things. That's nice things. It's just what I've always been saying. So when stuff start popping Twitter and all the social networks, I'm always saying nice things. What the hell is he talking about? And it's I need something for the fans to connect with. Let's just make nice things to move.
The TLA.
Mm-hmm.
Headlined it.
Yeah.
I went downstairs and I just was oh my gosh. People are everywhere.
That's how I went downstairs.
How did that feel when you come out on stage and you're like...
It was amazing. My manager, they came to the dressing room. He was turn cameras on, turn cameras. We had four cameras out. Turn cameras on. I gotta make an announcement. And we up here, we drink with each other. I'm you don't got time for that, yo. Come on, we trying to, relax. No, I got something to say. So cameras on, he's like, I just got away from the box office. We sold it out. And I'm like, what? Who saw this coming? We didn't have no extra radio promotion or, just nothing extra. It was just off of muscle. Then when I actually came in through the front of the TLA to start the show. And I walked in. I've never seen any people in TLA. Right. The first day of our show was somehow in my city.
So was that drunk show or was that regular chill? Let me know.
Yeah. That was drunk show. No, that was zoned out. Your mom pointed out one time. She was your eyes are different than I've ever seen your eyes when you're performing. Especially when you're in the zone and you're really into it. Zoned out. I don't know if it's a flash, I don't really remember stuff. I remember little transitions, talking to the crowd between the songs or whatever, but I did zoned out. I always drink on the stage, drink it before the show and after the show. So. But, I'm happy to say I haven't had a drink in 26 days today.
And counting.
And counting. Yeah.
So how do you, stay relevant and continue to get your name out there?
It's a lot of ways. Things that help with the MTV stuff, my video, I got two videos on MTV right now. So that's helping me stay relevant, separate myself from the other people that just wake up and want to be a rapper. It's showing that I'm actually doing this.
You're going to be in Atlanta too, right?
October. The A3C finally made the stage at A3C, so I'll be there October 3rd to 6th, and the show is the 5th. I might have two shows down there, so just follow my Twitter, my Instagram, and all that for that. Putting a whole bus trip together, taking everybody down. Shout out to Youssef, the whole veteran freshman movement. It's gonna be dope.
And I'm gonna put the link on my page, but it is Eventbrite, and anybody can go.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty dope. It's $400.
$400, you get round trip,
right.
You get tickets to the shows, all the shows, which is $100 value a day, and you get a hotel.
That's like a VIP groupie. You're gonna be a VIP groupie. So you need to go. People are not focusing 100% on music anymore.
I think it's important that people like you and like your music. You
know? Right.
Everybody's not gonna like you, everybody's not gonna like your music, but if somebody likes you and likes your music, or just like you, they're gonna support you somehow. Sometimes, you know, I hear a beat, it evokes a certain emotion, and it'll wrap up there. But sometimes I might have a dope ass line, and I just wanna build around that line or that concept. So every song is approached differently.
Okay, the one that I'm obsessed with is the one with
It was Bino's song originally. He brought it to the studio one day. We were working on Who You Love, me and man. And he brought it to the studio and played it. He was like, yo, when I start working on my solo project, I want to put this out. I want you to be on it. But, you know, I want you to play the drum. I mean, play the bartender. I'm like, Bino's playing the drum guy.
Right.
So far, and he's talking to the bartender, whatever. And it's like, you know, kind of like our relationship. Like, I'm, you know, the old kid that's kind of schooling him with things as he's coming up in music anyway. So, kind of like, was an extension of, you know, what we really go through anyway. And it was a real story, being able to really say and tell about his girl at the time and all of that. So all of that was legit. So he sung the hook, he had the hook, and that was it. He brings up One Shot. I'm like, oh yeah, let me put this on my album because you still ain't putting out a project.
Right.
And I want this song. He's like, all right, cool. And we sat over there that day in the studio, and he was still saying, he cried, and we don't talk about to each other. And, but people love that song because it's like relatable. It's like, you know, who hasn't gone through
it? Listen, it was on repeat. And I was like, if you don't sing it, like, because you could feel his emotion.
Because it was real. Those was real emotions.
I'm like, yes. And then even the video, I'm like, yo.
Yeah, that's, we kind of wrote the treatment for the video and the song at the same time.
I want to know exactly, like, what, when you see something, you like, nice things.
Everything. I say it too much, like I overdo it. This place is nice things. I'm loving the feng shui. This pillow is nice.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
This pillow is nice things. Shout out to Slingshots. It's actually, they're like G-Shot covers. So it's got your Moody right there, my signature, and got nice things on it. Which gotta have a G-Shot.
Where can they buy the watch and ensure it's
at? Everything is on chillmoody.com.
Pretty cool, sexy. Pretty cool. I mean, not like cool, sexy, welcome anything. You know, they're nice things. So where can they find you at?
Yeah, chillmoody.com, Twitter @chillmoody, Instagram is chillmoody, Vine is chillmoody, everything is chillmoody.
You're still on Vine?
I like Vine. I'm always doing Vine.
Why not?
You never seen that love? My Vine's so cool.
You should just be on Instagram about it.
Like I just started using
it.
I just started using Instagram videos, but I was doing like flashing on Vine. I was like, you gotta watch it. I was doing like special
effects. Are you funny because everybody's
saying, I wasn't doing funny things.
Funny.
I wasn't doing funny things at all. I was doing like a lot of like cool like stop motion shit, like other shit. But then Vine turned into this like comedian thing. And I kind of like fell off of it. But I don't like Instagram bit that much because it's like hard to maneuver for the stuff I was doing. But I use it now.
Oh, because you're a professional. He needs professional tools, guys. So you can follow him, like you said, on Chill Movie. Pretty simple. And we're gonna link it below. I wanna thank you for coming. This was an amazing interview. And make sure you go to thewalkofmannequins.com to get all my entertainment news, fashion, and music. See you soon.
Like I ain't got a fear in the world. Like, live for the day, tomorrow the world might. Never mind that for now, put your drinks in the air.